Ever wrestled with setting up and using a Ray cluster? Stay tuned and we'll unravel a super quick and easy approach to power your next level machine learning and data processing. Specifically, this video features a hands-on demonstration of managed Ray on Google Cloud. The Ray offering is actually within the Vertex AI suite. This is a suite of AI and ML services that goes far beyond just managed Ray. We'll need to enable the Vertex AI API before using the service. Next up, we need to create a cluster. This is a managed and pre-configured Ray cluster that we can use to run our Ray code, for example, our machine learning training or interface jobs. We're going to, as is usual with other setups like CubeRay, have a head node and worker pools. For low volume, high intensity work, the worker pool is often the important configuration. We can select the machine type, the machine size, and even have machines with GPUs. For example, we can have an A100 here with this machine type. Let's, however, for cost reasons, bring this down to, for example, an N1 standard 4 with an inexpensive accelerator like a T4. We could, of course, bump up the disk size for larger data loads. Note that if you're in a new project, you may have an issue with this Compute Engine network page. We'll get that working by heading over to Compute Engine and enabling that API. This is just that infrastructure layer underneath Ray. We need to have that service enabled in Google Cloud. Almost certainly, the Compute Engine service will already be on if you're using a pre-existing Google Cloud project. It doesn't look like the cluster creation will automatically refresh, so let's do that refresh manually and set up our cluster with the default VPC network. We'll also set up a private services connection with an automatically allocated IP range. There we are. That networking setup is done and dusted. Time to click and create the cluster, which might take a few minutes to be fully ready for action, but hang in there. Once our cluster is up and running, you'll notice that the recommended integration approach is to use the Colab Enterprise. This integration will give you a Jupyter-like Python environment for firing Ray code against our cluster. What's more, it also throws us an example notebook. To underpin these notebooks, when we create a cluster, we get a pre-configured runtime template. Thanks to this template, we get some Python configurations and libraries that fit like a glove with our Ray setup. From the template, we create runtimes employed by our notebooks, similar to the concept of kernels in Jupyter notebooks. Are you ready to dive into our example notebook? Let's connect to a runtime and get the ball rolling. The only template we have is exactly the one we need to create a new runtime. Easy decision, right? We'll just use the default name. The adventure kicks off with a few module imports and library initializations. Next, we're establishing a connection to that Ray cluster. Using the same approach, we can establish Ray connections in other Python environments. Imagine doing this with Vertex AI pipelines, Spark jobs on Dataproc, or even custom Compute Engine or Kubernetes Engine services. All right, let's verify if our initialization code works. Indeed, all looks good. While we're at it, why don't we create a quick and simple remote function within this environment? We'll run this function with some parallelization. It looks like we missed an import here, but that's a quick fix. Note that our four executions took 1 second. That is, we're running 4 seconds worth of processing in parallel. Why is that, you ask? Well, that's because of our powerful ray cluster armed with at least 4 cores. Just to be extra clear about what we've crafted here, we have a ray cluster and we're communicating with it using a Jupyter-like Python environment. However, this whole process is with turnkey managed services thanks to the power of Vertex AI platform. Hit us up with your questions in the comment section if you have any. Thanks for watching, and remember to please enjoy responsibly.